this problem, we have two initially identical piston and cylinder arrangements, and I'll try to draw them about as identically as I can, but they're intended to be identical. All right, they're insulated, so there's no heat transfer across them. We'll call this one A and this one B, and we initially have the gases at the same temperature and 2 bar pressure, and then we compress both of them to 1/10 of their original volume. So we'll say 1/10 times initial volume, V naught. And we want to find out if this one is compressed reversibly and if B is irreversibly compressed, which one will have the higher final pressure. All right, so if B is compressed irreversibly, all right, then that means that it takes more work in order to do it. The way it would be compressed irreversibly is if you had a pressure gradient across the piston. So if you had a significant delta P here in order to do the work, all right, and you would be doing more work than was necessary because you'd be having a higher external pressure that was doing the work, and therefore the work that you were adding to the system would be greater for tank B than tank A. All right, there's no heat being transferred in this system because the system is well insulated. All right, and so therefore our energy balance for both cases is that delta U is equal to the work. And therefore, because there's more work for tank B, then also the internal energy change is greater for tank B during this process. All right, in both cases, we'll get an increase in the internal energy by doing work on the system, but that increase will be greater for tank B. Now, the next question is how this translates into pressure. We can make an ideal gas assumption, for example, and in that case, then delta U is a function only of temperature, and if delta U sub B is greater than delta U sub A, that means the temperature change, which is going to be an increase because the internal energy is increasing, the temperature change for tank B will be greater, and therefore the final temperature in tank B will be greater. So TB is greater than TA. It's true even though the final volumes are given in the problem statement to be equal. All right, and so the temperature is higher in B, the volume is the same, and therefore by the ideal gas law, we know that PB over PA is equal to TB over TA, and therefore the final pressure in tank B is also greater than the final pressure in tank A.